Welcome to follow Jukola Live pre-show here from Jukola and Kangasala. We are getting ready for this year's Jukola and Venla Relay starting in these beautiful fields and terrains close to Kangasala and Tampere. This year Jukola Live is something new. We have totally new background for the Jukola broadcast and some new faces also. May I present you our commentators, Vili Virtanen and Kalle Rantala. Welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you, thank you.
Hey, thanks, what's up?
That's everything's well and nice. We have now, when we are waiting for Jukola to start, one night to go. What are your feelings?
I'm quite exciting and I'm very looking forward to see interesting races, both in women and also in men races.
Yeah, we had just a little talk with the course setters and it seems to be a really exciting relay tomorrow.
The terrain is quite a lot different than it was last year in Lahti-Hollola when we were running downwards more than upwards. What's the terrain today or tomorrow?
I think that terrain is quite typical in this area near Tampere, and I think every orienteer knows those forests quite well.
Yeah, it would be quite surprising for Swedish and Norwegian to come here in the middle of Finland. It's this Hame region is really demanding because there is lots of, like, its detail richness is really high, and then there's lots of stony ground also.
And now when we are starting Jukola Live for you, you will be hosting, what kind of show are we waiting for?
We are trying to do for you an interesting show with the GPS live cam from forest and also try to keep you knowing what's happening all the time.
Yeah, I think it will be the orienteers will make the show and we just try to explain what happens, most of all.
That's true. So an exciting Venla and Jukola relay ahead of us, and during this broadcast you will know a little bit more about the upcoming Venla and Jukola relay when we are going to have some guests here in this broadcast. Stay tuned and follow Jukola Live.
So, it's just one day until the D-Day comes. How excited are you at the moment?
On grade from 1 to 10, I would say 8.
8? So it's rising?
Yeah, it's rising. Well, I would say I'm pretty excited. It's nice to see how the competitors will like our courses.
Yeah, the course setting for Jukola is one of the greatest experience for a course setter, I guess. How did you divide this thing between you two, or have you done this everything together all the time?
I think we have done this field work together. Yeah. I think I have said in many cases that maybe 70% of our field trips in the forest we have done it together. So it's we are done both races, Venla and Jukola relay together.
Petteri, you have lived your whole life here in Kangasala. How does it feel to be here in the forest and plan these legs?
It's bit of a weird sensation to go to a familiar terrain and think that there's like 20,000 runners coming up here and we are planning the courses for them, because for me the terrain is quite familiar. Yeah, so to give that great experience to all the other runners as well.
Jarkko, you were the course setter also in 2011 in Salpajukola, Vehkalahti. Did you learn something?
Yeah, one lesson I have learned. And women's first, like, second last control, there are more space for women to punch the control, though. So I think that there won't be any fights this year.
Okay. That sounds really good. It's coming late night already, and do you have something to do still?
No, actually, just one check that we're gonna check the starting point. The others have built it there, and we're gonna go and check that it's okay. So that's the one thing left for us.
Okay, and then to sauna to warm up a little bit for tomorrow.
Yeah, I think we have VIP evening today in Kangasala Talo.
That sounds really good. So I wish you both good luck for tomorrow. It's your great day, I guess.
Yeah, thank you. I wish all the runners the best of luck and good orienteering.
Yeah, thanks.
I have two runners from Halden SK and Göteborg IF, Marika Teini, Kirsi Nurmi. Welcome to our pre-show for Jukola Live. Marika, great two runs and podiums from last weekend from World Cup Vihti. How that feels now?
Well, actually now it feels better maybe than in the weekend, because I was quite nervous before the runs, because I didn't know about my shape. And yeah, it was nice to see that all the work which I have been doing during the winter has paid something.
Yeah, that's nice to hear. You speculated after Saturday's race that how your angle will be, and are you going to run on Sunday also? How does the angle feels now?
Well, it was actually quite good after Sunday, but these terrains around Tampere are quite stony, and well, it's not perfect, but I think I can tape it fine enough to run tomorrow, and so it doesn't slow me down.
Both of you are living now abroad, Kirsi in Sweden, Göteborg, and Marika in Halden. What do you think? How does that makes life and routines different to live abroad than being home in Finland?
Of course, it was a big adjustment in the beginning, but now I've been living there nearly 7 years, so yeah, it feels like a second home to me by now. But yeah, of course, it's a home in a different way than being in Finland. But I think as an orienteer, it has been really good to get to live in a different environment and run on many different maps and be in a really good training environment in Gothenburg. So I think it has really developed me as an orienteer.
Well, I have been just a couple of months in Halden so far, but yeah, I agree with Kirsi that it's good to have some change and to see different places. And I think it has been also helping me to go forward this year to try something new.
You have trained earlier in Finland. Does the Swedish and Norwegian teams, does they do something different? Because those are the teams that are really top places in big relays year after year.
At least for our team, IFK Göteborg, I think doing things together in our everyday life is a big thing behind our success. Most of our runners live in Gothenburg, and I think that's a big difference compared to like many clubs in Finland where people live all across the country. So it's kind of easier to develop that team spirit when you know each other really well and do stuff together even outside orienteering on an almost everyday basis.
Yeah, also in Norway we train quite much together, and also, well, there is much more organized orienteering trainings for runners, and I think that's the main difference between Finland and Norway. And in Norway, everyone plans their trainings much more like according to the orienteering things. They don't go almost never to run track intervals, for example. It's more like specific to orienteering the training.
Do you train with men also?
Yeah, most of our trainings are both for men and women, and I think it's been really interesting to see how, like, the men do the trainings, and yeah.
Yeah, it's the same for us.
Okay. Kirsi, you are studying in Göteborg now. How is it different? Is it easy or difficult to balance life, training between the orienteering and studying?
For me, it was quite hard in the beginning. Like, I had really bad results during my first years as a senior, but I think now I found a good. Have found a pretty good balance, so I think, yeah, it just took some time, but it's definitely possible, and it's like where I'm right now, I'm really happy about my situation, and it feels like it works really well.
Okay, that's good to hear. Marika, you have lived in Joensuu, which many people think that it's the paradise for the orienteers in Finland. Now you live in Hallen, and I think quite many things that's the orienteering paradise in the world. Is that true?
Yeah, I would say it's true. Well, maybe Joensuu is paradise for orienteer from May to November, but the winter is quite long. But otherwise, yeah.
Okay. What are your expectations for tomorrow's race? How good teams do you have, and what kind of competitions we are waiting?
I think we have a really great team. Everybody in our team is in really good shape, and really they are really like good orienteers, so I'm not worried about our team. But what comes to the race, I think it will be really demanding and technical, and it will definitely not be easy. And there are many strong teams fighting up there, so we definitely have to do our job to make a good result.
Yeah, I also expect it to be really challenging, also physically and technically, but yeah, we have also a good team with four national team runners, and I don't see any reasons why we couldn't be at the top, but well, it requires four really good runs tomorrow.
Okay, thank you and good luck.
So, here we are with two main favorites, or at least two favorite teams for Jukola 2019 Kangasala Jukola. Max-Peter Beimer from IFK Göteborg, how are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling great. We've been out in the forest on the training maps, and it looks really nice, and we're very motivated to be here and to run the Jukola tomorrow.
Right. That's good. How about Severi?
Yeah, of course we are really excited. It's an event we have been waiting for years. From the moment we heard that Kangasala is hosting a Jukola 2019, so it's really exciting times at the moment.
Okay, so it's feeling like a home Jukola for Tampere and Pyrintö guys at the moment?
Yes, definitely. It's only like half an hour away from Tampere, and it's the kind of terrain we have been training the whole of our lives, so it really feels home.
Yeah, so really familiar terrain. How about you? Is it similar to Göteborg area at all?
We always try to find some similar terrains, and at Bachult there is where we've had our Jukola tests, there is some nice terrain, so yeah.
IFK Göteborg has been dominating almost Tiumila for the last 3 years, and now you have won also Jukola 2017. Will you win this year also?
Oh, we will do our very best. As I said, we're very motivated, and especially beating Tampere and Pyrintö and Kove at their home soil would be just fantastic.
How does it sound?
I don't agree, but we'll, like Göteborg, we will give our best, and I mean it's gonna be a really demanding race in many ways. I'm sure about it. So that's something we have been preparing for, and the best one will always win.
IFK Göteborg has been really stable all the relays for last years. What's your secret? Is it the routines in the winter time, or what gives you so high stable performance level all the time?
We train a lot together, and we have some good trainings around in Gothenburg, and I think we motivate and push each other, and we're all the runners can run by themselves, and very technically we're all very good, so that's probably the secret, and we run as a team.
Yeah. Sounds really good. Tampereen Pyrintö has been rising to the highest level of orienteering for the last maybe 5 to 6 years. You have been going up in the relays all the time. Do you train together a lot, or what's your secret?
Yeah, well, I don't know exactly how it's in Göteborg, but we are a bit more spread. Of course, there are up to 10 guys living in Tampere, but then also other parts in Finland, and then we have, of course, our international friends. But then we are, what really keeps us together is the training center we are having every winter for roughly two months in somewhere south. Southern Spain, and that's a place where we train a lot together, and where we kind of build our team spirit.
Can you say something like a positive comment to each other about what do you want to copy from each other's teams, or from Severi, from Max, or something like that?
I don't know. They have very nice presentations of their team. Yeah. We're a little bit jealous about that.
So you should try to hire some director also, or
yeah, if we can get the same stability as they have in the big relays, then we can gladly give some help with the directing their presentation videos.
Right. What would you like to say for foreign audience which will follow tomorrow the relay? What is the thing you want audience to focus on?
I don't know, Team Mila, we had a big gap, so maybe it wasn't that exciting, but I think Jukola, it's a tighter relay, so I think there will be a lot of intense fights and things happening during the night and then during the finishing day, so yeah, that's what we look forward to. So.
How about Severi?
Yeah, I'm sure the audience is glad to see some really big mistakes on the northwest hillside on the other side of the road there. So that's probably something that they are looking forward to.
Yeah, that sounds really promising. I wish you both best of luck for tomorrow and for the night. And I hope you will challenge each other as much as you can. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Remember to sign in and follow us on live.jukola.com. We will start broadcasting 1:55 local time.